the next session, which is the digital governance post-COVID-19. And we have on this panel joined by Dr. Nawaljeet Kapoor. He's Joint Secretary, Ministry of Tribal Affairs. Mr. P.B. Salim, he's Secretary from Chief Minister's Office, Government of West Bengal. Mr. M. Girija Shankar, Commissioner, Panchayati Raj and Rural Development from Andhra Pradesh, and Ms. Anu Jain, Deputy Director, Ministry of Labor and Employment. This discussion is again around COVID, but we are not talking during. We are going to be talking about post-COVID, the learnings from whatever we have gone through so far. And for most government departments, this transformation already is underway. You know, this is what I have gathered from the discussions since morning, that there is an extreme amount of transformation is happening. How to go on to the next level? The country has to keep running. And actually, even during the closed down period, there have been problems that we faced. But the strong shoulders of the government and the public sector, you know, we are going to be sailing through. So we are setting our sail accordingly. Relief has come by way of direct benefit transfers, provident fund benefits, labor, mitigating, migrating, you know, a large organization of digital human resource management, so on and so forth. So three questions in front of us. What were the key challenges, solutions implemented, and impetus being given to digitalization post-COVID? So with this, I invite our first speaker, Dr. Nawaljeet Kapoor, and request him to take 2 minutes to make his submission.
Good morning, everybody. I know challenges and problems always bring opportunities. It was the last week of the financial year when budget was going to be released to all the stakeholders. We had interview of NSP fixed on 17th March. We had workshop of tribal talent pool fixed on 12th March and 3rd April. There was a tribal festival which was going to be organized. All tickets and travels were already booked. All schools closed down. Tribal migrants started coming back to the cities. It was the peak season for selling of minor forest produce. Tribal artisans were not able to sell their products. Lakhs of students who are dependent upon the scholarships, they were also waiting for their amounts to be released. Various tribal research institutions, which were doing the surveys at the field level, they were also not in a position to do that. So what was the solution for this? The only solution was digitalization. Our entire office was paperless even before COVID. So not even a single file was paper file. So as far as our office is concerned, we were able to process all the files on e-office in the last week of March. And even on 29th of March, when physically some of the papers are to be sent to the accounts office, we were able to release 1,000 crores on a single day just by click of a mouse. As all of you know, DBT mission is a silent revolution, and our vision of Honorable Prime Minister on DBT. So we were able to release 1,000 crores in the accounts of the scholars and in the accounts of the NGOs and to the state governments on the even last day. And in last 3 months, we have released about 25 crores of rupees through DBT. So schools are doing e-classes. We opened the Haat Bazaars also with the help of the Ministry of Home Affairs. But then we shifted to e-commerce and e-market. We also, during this period, came through Sickle Cell Support Corner, for which portal was launched by Honorable Minister. We also developed online repository of tribal research. For resolving issue of tribal migrants, we also developed a tribal migrant repository. And last but not the least, since you are saying I have a very few time, only 2 minutes, all the festivals which are to be held physically, we just ensured we are coming with a digital platform. And from the next week, all the festivals, they will be happening on the Facebook Live page. And 750 tribal groups, they will be showing their art and culture, and even painting competitions. We are planning to hold it on through e-medium this week. So all our inter-ministerial meetings now, they are happening on through Zoom, through our video. In the last, even during lockdown, we have NGOs which are located on the Leh-Ladakh border, on the China border, in the remotest of the area. We always feel that it is only the big cities where we have this connectivity. But I'm happy to inform that the selection process of the NGOs was totally done through VCs. We were able to connect with 80 NGOs from all over the India. So I can proudly say what we have done in last 3 months during this period of lockdown. It was not even possible in 1 year. Now we don't have any physical travel, no wastage of time, unnecessary expenditure has reduced. My junior staffs are also working from home. What we did, we gave their official PCs at their homes. We gave them internet connections also. Even at 9 o'clock in the evening, we are just conversing through the Zoom meetings and other channels available.
All right. So it's an interesting piece of information when it comes from the government, because generally once the office is shut, the connect with the official work also gets missed. So I'll come back to you with questions towards the end. So in the meanwhile, let me now invite Mr. Salim, Secretary, Chief Minister's Office, Government of West Bengal, as to, what has been the state's response, because you are directly working with the Honorable Chief Minister.
Hi, good morning, everyone. Since the time given to every panelist is just 2 minutes, I don't think we'll have to go into details of the topic. I'll restrict my suggestion or response to 2 points. Number one, of course, whether you like it or not, COVID has been a turning point in the human history, the history of our country. Maybe like the last world war, maybe the partition of a country, this has been a turning point in the human history. So we, all of us, every aspect of human life, whether it is governance, whether it is entertainment, whether it is education, every aspect has turned digital. Now, the alarming part of it is, of course, all of us have adapted to the transformation because we are all resourceful persons. My only concern, my submission to all of you would be like the alarming part of it because of the digital divide in our country. The digital internet penetration of our country is just about 30%. Whereas 70% of the population lives in rural areas. Now, all of us who are living mostly in urban, peri-urban areas, we have internet penetration of around 90-98%. So those who are not that fortunate, not that resourceful, they are really at the receiving end of this transformation. Now, government governance has transformed because of necessity. All of us have transformed. Every state has transformed. Maybe the degree varies. We have also taken a lot of initiatives. I'll not go into details of that. But I'll just leave this thought before you, our Honorable Chairman, Scotch Group, Samir Kochar Sahib is also there. So this is an area all of us should think of. The government should think, the private sector, the civil society. Otherwise, an entire generation of our country is going to suffer because of this. Because those who are in class 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, those who are in the rural area, those who are unable to, they are those who are losing classes month after month. This is definitely going to reflect in their future life and, of course, in our country's future. Thank you so much.
Well, thank you. So this is a perspective from the state. So now over to Mr. Girija Shankar, Commissioner Panchayati Raj and Rural Development from Andhra Pradesh.
Yeah. Good morning, Gurucharan. Am I audible? Yes, I'm up, raise your hand.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you very much for this opportunity. Let me speak from the implementation perspective. In any disaster, as you know, people look for protection and assistance. And COVID-19 being such a unprecedented kind of disaster and also a mischievous kind of a disaster, then there have been many challenges, particularly from the government to citizen services. So the main challenge is on the service delivery. Second, on there has been a challenge on redefining the whole the delivery system, and also business process reengineering, all such kinds of major challenges. So what we have done is, in Andhra Pradesh particularly, we have a system of village volunteers. We got 2.6 lakh village volunteers spread over all over the state. There is one volunteer for every 50 households. So through these volunteers, we have distributed the ration and also the pension, all this. Mainly, they have also done the door-to-door survey of any COVID-like symptomatic patients and all those. So this has helped in controlling, containing the COVID, and also providing the assistance to the people. Then we also have village secretariats, and we got 13,000 gram panchayats and 11,000 village secretariats. Then all these 11,000 village secretariats, we have 1.2 lakh government functionaries working at the village level. So they're all stay put at village level. So they have been pressed into service, so they have extended the services. But main challenge was on educating people, motivating people to wear the mask, and also maintaining the social distance, and any symptomatic person should be taken to hospital, nearby hospital. All these have been taken care of by it. So COVID related and also the governance related problems could have been sorted out, have been addressed through this system of both village volunteers and also the village level secretariat staff. The main solutions that we have come up is, anyway, the training and the motivation of all the village functionaries or the village volunteers, and all the entire machinery has been through the virtual platforms. So that has been taken care of. Then main thing is on coming up with the suitable or relevant kind, e-solutions. So basically the migrants movement, the reverse migration has been taken care of through a online portal, and also ensuring that there is a tie up from the borders to the end of the other side of the state border, and also sending them to the villages and ensuring them that they are all quarantined, and also providing the required food, everything, till they take up some local jobs. Then another thing is that the e-pass system, all those all this, but since I'm looking after the MNREGA, the Mahatma Gandhi NREGP program, what we have done is through the village volunteers, so all those who have come on reverse migration, who return to the villages, we have mapped and then provided job cards under NREGA program. So they have 2.7 lakh job cards we have given. Those who are not members of the job cards, the family has a job card but not a member, so they have been included. And then those deactivated job cards got reactivated. So about 15 lakh new labor, that is workers, NREGA workers have joined the workforce, and about 57 lakh workers have turned up, and during the peak period in May, June, and then we could provide. But in all these times, we did not allow any kind of problem to crop up, like the COVID-related problem to crop up, because we have developed a mobile app through which we ensured that the social distance is maintained at the work site. And also before and after the work, then the washing is done. We provided soaps, and so masks have been provided. State has provided 15 crore masks, one per every citizen kind. So all this has helped in managing. Touch wood, there has been no COVID problem.
We have controlled post this.
So these are the few things, but the main still more challenges that we need to maintain. So there's digitalization is one aspect, but apart from that, there are other problems, like we have to maintain that social cohesion, because there are psychological social problems coming up, cropping up.
Girdashukhaji, in fact, these are the issues which will remain with us.
Yeah.
And that has been a historic problem, because to keep people educated, to keep, maintain the communication lines with them, do the IEC activities more effectively, so that instead of shouting on the street, they should walk along with the administration and give their complete support. So I'm sure those are the things, as we move forward, we will also achieve.
Yeah.
I'll come back to you. Let me in the meanwhile invite Ms. Anu Jain from Ministry of Labour and Employment.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Girija.
Hello. Good morning to one and all. Myself, Anu Jain from Ministry of Labour and Employment. Now, if talking about my own project, Samadhan Portal, so And talking about in the COVID situation, I would say that COVID in a way has helped in motivating labor to like Samadhan is a platform wherein the laborers are supposed to come down and register their industrial disputes online with the help of the mobile also. They don't need to use the mouse. They can do it by their handset as well. So during COVID, because of the social distancing and lockdown and everything, I think it motivated all the more the laborers. And in fact, it came in handy for them so that they can put up their disputes online with the help of Samadhan. So the only difference I would say in implementation is that before, in the pre-COVID time, they would go down to the conciliation officer's office for the conciliation proceedings in person. But during the social distancing time, conciliation officers are doing it in field with the help of video conferencing. So I would say that Samadhan is totally digitized in the COVID era. And now talking about my ministry, Ministry of Labor and Employment as a whole. So Ministry of Labor and Employment, during the COVID time, during the lockdown especially, had set up 20 controlling offices wherein they would coordinate with the laborers, like their grievances. For example, someone has been ousted from their job. So they could put up their grievance via they would call, they would put it online via email and everything. And the ministry was coordinating with them. Ministry was also counseling them, like in order to maintain their psychological balance. So especially to the stranded migrants and those who were like not comfortable in their workplace, like they were ousted or they were given the half pay or they were just told to just get off. So, and ministry has also coordinated with other ministries in order to provide the affordable housing, you know, and everything, the facilities to the basic amenities to the laborers.
So we have, three different perspectives from the central government, straight from the chief minister's office, as well as right from the ground, which is an Andhra experience. The feeling that I get is that a whole lot of things have moved on the ground. You know, people have started receiving their benefits perhaps better than before. And they've also been aligned, keeping future in mind. But do you think, any one of you can answer this question, that the government performs under pressure? If this COVID pressure wasn't there, the things would not have moved as fast as they have.
I'd like to add something. We were working on a very... we were having some dream project of going online as leaders. You won't imagine, we were trying that program since November 2019.
Yeah.
But we were not able to launch it. This is a Facebook-funded program where there was a need of digital entrepreneurship. Even in the month of March, we were just struggling. And you would not imagine that we launched this program during peak of the COVID. And in just one and a half month, we have received 20,000 applications from mentors and mentees from all over India, gold.tribal.gov.in. This we did in the COVID period. You must have heard of Garib Kalyan Rozgar Yojana, which Honorable Prime Minister has started for this six states. I'm the nodal officer of one of the district in MP. So we have held almost six VCs with them. Earlier, when a similar program, I was Central Nodal Officer for Water Mission, you won't imagine it used to take 3 days for me to go to Punjab and my office work was...
I can empathize, you know, how full of hurdles the journey has been and suddenly the things have changed. Girija Shankarji, what's your experience? I mean, are you also working under similar pressure?
Yeah. Pressure, in fact, it provides an opportunity, I must say. During this COVID, we worked almost, 14 hours a day and all that. So, but still, during this time, to provide the G2C services, we had to put in all the mobile-based apps and then in place, and then all the volunteers, 2.6 lakh volunteers have been provided with smartphones. We have put them to use. And then all the applications through the secretariat have been processed. So this has provided a great opportunity. And also in the entire health system, the trainings and the entire basic livelihoods that we provide through MNREGA. So we could provide trainings and then we disciplined everybody. So this is definitely a great opportunity, I must say.
So in fact, you know, it dispels all kinds of dissatisfaction level or otherwise the common criticism that government does not perform. Government does perform. And this is the shining example of having gone through in the last 4 to 5 months, you know, coming from, starting from where and where we have reached today, that we don't care if Corona happens. The show must go on. We are walking on the street. We are working in our offices. And all the hands have been put together. All the efforts have been put together to put the country back on track. So excellent work. Thank you very much, gentlemen. And
can I ask a question?
Yes, please go ahead.
My question is for Mr. Salim. Mr. Salim?
I think he's got busy with some discussion in his office.
Okay, let's carry on. I'll ask him later.
Okay, we'll get him. I will get him back. So we have the next round of poll coming in.
At this just one minute. I want to raise a small question.
Go ahead.
Not exactly a question, but a suggestion. See, we post-COVID, we are all working from home and using technology. And the the expenditure mostly born for is on the internet connectivity, right? So when we are talking about reforms, administrative reforms and so many other reforms, does it mean that since we are not going to office and mostly working from home using no tours, no travel, is it going to reduce the government expenditure?
Certainly, it is going to reduce as far as...
No, but should it be reflected? When we are talking about outcomes, will it be reflected as the outcome of the corona pandemic? Because that amount is going to be quite heavy.
Certainly, as far as the officer expenditure on traveling is concerned, it is going to reduce. For a single meeting here happening in Delhi, from 23 states, principal secretaries, their staff used to come almost every month. And we also every month used to travel to different states. Now all those things have virtually stopped.
And I agree. Long time back, almost 10, 15 years back, we introduced video conferencing for the states when they used to come to planning commission for plan discussion. At least 3 to 4 times the officials will be coming, the minister will be coming. Finally, it got by using video conferencing over NICNET, that number of visits reduced to maybe one meeting with the minister level. And sometimes when there is a query, maybe at some senior level, right? But the visibility was not there. So can some report come out saying that this is the outcome because of the pandemic? The expenditure, government expenditure has reduced so drastically, because it's going to be an appreciable amount.
I feel time
so what we're going to do is I'll request offline. Mr. Salim online, okay, would like to ask your question.
Yeah, Mr. Salim, my question was, what was the single biggest challenge for West Bengal? Because, you know, during the pandemic, and how did you overcome it? I mean, was it center-state relations or it was finance? Was it something internal to you? What was the biggest challenge?
Mr. Salim, are you able to hear? Looks like there is some audio issue. Looks like we're not able to gather. So we move on with this. We thank everybody on the panel for joining us and.